6, cancel those out. 113, so I'll add, that would be 6 here. That's not there. 113, so I'm gonna add 13.
Hi, babes.
Hello. There's still a little pile out there, but it's gotta get cold. It was the last batch we worked on.
Okay, ready? Come on. We have all these are trimmed, deboned. All the wax and fat is removed. And we have some big chunks in here that we're gonna use for stew meat. And we're gonna separate stew meat to burger meat. We're not doing any steaks. We do have some tenderloin and backstrap that we will keep. But today we're going to have burger and stew meat. We might make some jerky and we might do some sausage. We're not sure yet. Pieces like this that came off the back leg, there's a lot of sinew in there. We're gonna chunk those up for burger. These are also pieces that came off the back leg, and I'm gonna chunk those up for stew. And then these are some nice pieces. I think that's probably it for stew. Everything else looks like it's going to be for burger. May have that one too, but that's what's left.
So a lot of the leg meat and the muscle meat, it has a lot of sinew in it. That's what we're gonna do with our burger. But it's important not to cut it lengthwise with the muscle, but to cut against the sinews and cut them short so that the pieces of sinew aren't long and stringy because they'll get bound up in the grinder. But if you cut them short, you don't even know they're there in the finished product. So, doing the Michael Jackson thing, I nipped the tip of my finger. I put on the new skin, which is nice. It keeps it from bleeding and all that kind of stuff. But just to be safe, so I don't put blood on our food, I've got these heavy-duty mechanics latex gloves that I pulled out of the shop that work really well for this whenever I do happen to nick myself, because it happens once in a while. So. Live by the sword, die by the sword. Okay.
Do it.
You do it.
No, you do it. You can't do that.
You can't?
No.
Okay, so what we're going to do now is we're going to start packaging everything. We've got it all processed down to what we want. This has just got basically our tenderloins and our back straps. We're going to package those up because we found back strap from a doe last year. Generally, the black writing was, if we're pulling in multiple animals, black is my writing, Angel's got like blue or green, the kids got different colors, so we know whose deer was what. But since we have leftover black already, we're just going to go ahead and change color because this is the only deer we're going to have this year, and we're going to go with orange. So we'll do all the writing in orange. That way it's just quick. You look in there, you're like, we're not eating the orange today, we're eating the black because we want to get it, last year's gone.
Yes.
And then we'll use these zip ties as opposed to these zip ties. When we do the hamburger and the hamburger tubes, we'll use the proper color zip tie as well. Even if we write on it in black, it's about the color zip tie that's on it. It tells you that it's hamburger and it's from this year, not last year. And then we'll do something else, like with the stew meat, we'll put that in hamburger tubes, just like the hamburger. It'll have an orange zip tie, just like the hamburger, but we'll put a second zip tie on it, like this maybe, that way it denotes that it's a stew meat, it's solid chunks, it's not hamburger, but it can all get stored the same because it's all in the same tubes. You'll see it all coming up here real soon.
Oh,
2.0 perfectly. 2.0 pounds, which looks like 20 pounds, which is absurd.
2 pounds, 1.1 ounce, so it would be 4 pounds, 1.1 ounce?
Yeah.
It wouldn't just be 4 pounds, 1 ounce?
Could be. Okay. It's just 1.1, that's 1/10 of an ounce. Like this, like...
Okay.
It's that much.
All right, man, you're in charge. Write it
out. 4 pounds, 1 ounce is what I would do.
Oh. So, well, that's what I would do. Four. Why are we arguing? I'm just going to throw these in our freezer in here.
Okay. Excuse me, we only need to...
You want to eat that for dinner, Mom?
Yeah. Pretty sure you put a deer hair in there.
Gross. Okay. Remember to pick that out.
Whatever, that's somebody else's problem. That's future me's problem.
Well, if I cook it long enough, it'll just break down, right?
I guess. Okay, we're going to check venison. Check. It says not for sale. Burger or sausage. We're going to write stew. 1 pound... 8 ounces. There we go. 2021.
Thank you.
Come on, kid.
Oh, you like eating your meat?
Stop it.
What? You started it.
Just because you have meat on your face, you do. Dun dun dun! What next? Burger?
Yeah, we have to grind the burger.
Yay. But, did you freeze it yet?
It's in the freezer. And I'm gonna need you because it's heavy.
So.
Okay, I'm gonna need you to write on the board, okay?
Nipping. Nip. Are we putting this in the freezer out there?
Yes. Oh, look, advertising.
L-E-M, Lem, not a sponsor.
Not a sponsor.
But willing to accept.
Yet.
Willing to sell out to Lem.
Look at all that meat. You carry it very well.
Oh, only at the waistline, baby.
What are we doing now?
We're grinding.
Oh, tasty, tasty.
Okay, so we're gonna go through and start grinding all of our hamburger. This stores our pieces, okay? And you can see I have a coarse grind on here and this is a fine grind. I'm gonna grind all that meat once and then I'm gonna grind it twice with this. It's gonna get loud, so please enjoy the music while your party is reached. Seen her spoon some of this back in there. That's because we want to make sure that all the big chunks get through it for a first grind. We're going to add the second grind. And we're back at it. Beautiful lean red meat that you're ever gonna get your hands on right there. Okay, so starting with the sausage, 5 pounds of sausage. We need to go pick up some real fatty pork to grind up and mix in with that. We'll have to do that tomorrow. So we're gonna cut out the 4 pounds of venison to go with the 1 pound of pork to make the sausage. The jerky, we will cut out that 5 pounds, mix that up. It has to rest overnight in the fridge before we can make the jerky.
Bin for the doggo. Buddy, we're making
me
some scrappies.
Dog scraps! Dun, dun, dun! Cracker with some cheese spread on it.
Bread.
At least it's your butt down.
all going naked.
Carnivore.
This is a whole bunch of premium dog food. And what it is all those the little slimy pieces, the waxy fat, the bloodshot. Some of it had hair and dirt on it. Dogs don't care. They're gonna love this. I'm gonna throw it on the griddle. Cook it all up for them because they like their meat cooked for some reason, because they're not wild animals, they're domesticated. Lay this out one big giant meat patty on the griddle. We'll use it on top of their cheap dog food. We'll just throw a couple handfuls of this every night for the next couple weeks.
Yeah.
And they'll be super happy with that. So why waste it? I figured, you know, the animal honored us with its life. The least we can do is use every bit that we can find a way to eat. This is the entire carcass. This is what's left. This, there's a place in the woods where everybody around here goes. I'll go out there and dump this with my four-wheeler. It'll be gone in a couple days. Crows will eat it, coyotes will eat it. Any other scavengers that come along will chow on these bones. And it all goes back to Nate.
Okay, we'll zero it out. So we need, what, 4 pounds?
4 pounds for the brats.
For the brats tomorrow.
Yes, because we need to add 20% pork fat to the brats.
Okay. 2 pounds. So you have spices here, right? Deer packet here. We try to kill all our animals and stack them all up and then do all of this at the same time. That's not always the case. We had to get this deer processed because elk season is next week. Maybe we'll get an elk season. Maybe we'll get an elk during elk season. Maybe we won't. But we don't do this often enough to have a good system. Every year we're figuring it out again from scratch. We are not experts, but not being an expert has never stopped us from starting.
And that's brat.
Okay, so we found a better way to do this. Bag, just the tube from the jerky squirter. We'll see the jerky squirter when we make jerky tomorrow. But it's just a tube from it. So much better. Much quicker. Okay, so that deer hanging in the shop with no skin, but still had the head on and no guts. Okay, so it was just a naked deer with the head on. Was somewhere between 65 and 68 pounds, all right? So real quick, put down in the comments, what's the weight of the finished product that you think we pulled out of that? So I'm gonna throw it together right here. So we got 20 pounds, 12 ounces of burger. I'll add that 12 over here and we'll take the 20 here. 4 pounds, 1 ounces, so I'll add the 4. 1 8, 1 8, those are both 3 pounders, so I'll add 6. Cancel those out. 113, so I'll add, wait, that would be 6 here. That's not there. 113, so I'm gonna add 13 here and 1 there. Brats, 4 pounds, jerky, 5 pounds. So add this, 12 and 1, 13, 13 and 13 is 26.
26, right? Yep.
So 26 minus 16, zero that out, 1, 0, so 10 ounces is the total, and one more on this end. Okay, so 20, 21, right? 25, 31, 32, 36, 41, 41 pounds, 10 ounces, that's how much we got. Out of a 65 to 68 pound carcass, and you know, a portion of that's the head and the antlers. So we did pretty good, because normally you can usually count on about 33%, about 1/3 of the hanging weight is what you'll end up with meat. Plus, we have another probably 10 pounds in waste that's just ground up for dog food. So I think we did all right. So come back tomorrow and we'll start making some sausages out of that other meat that we got 4 pounds of brats, and we need to grind up a little bit of pig butt and make some sausages, and I can't wait. So, now put down in the comments, were you right? Were you close? You know, is it worth it to take it to a butcher when you're only getting 30% of your meat back instead of 50% or better? I don't know. Maybe for you, not for us.